His back, but I still did it. It's gonna take ages, that's what. Ew, that's disgusting. tell me there's gonna be more of them. There's gonna be more of them, isn't there?
Revelio.
There's another one, obviously. Great. I'm just gonna be safe again. Because, like, I'm going down. There's more than one. Why? One at a time is enough. But three at a time. That's I'm tempted to put it on easy, but I kind of, you know.
Leviosa!
Technically, I think that was kind of cheating, being on a ridge there, but I don't know, I'll take it. Definitely, I'll take it.
Revelio!
Is nothing else right? Nothing else gonna pop out at me. It's like that'd be totally not cool. And you can't swim any faster. That's pretty. Oh, it's bright.
Why would I need a piece of toast?
Is it a crumb?
I suppose that's where it goes.
Pretty cool.
Revelio.
Anything else out here now? Sure.
Doesn't appear to be connected to the missing pages. Best hang on to it for now.
Could it be a visitor? The name's Richard Jackdaw. I was a student, just like you, about a century ago. How in the world did you find this place?
A house elf named Scrope sent me. Said I might find a black family ring here.
Ah. Sorry to say, I sold the ring a long time ago. Poor Scrope. Still holds a candle for Apollonia, I reckon. Can't say I blame him. I stole all these treasures just to impress her. Alas, 'twas to no avail. I thought a secret map I pilfered from Peeves would pique her interest. But she simply rolled her eyes. What would I want with yellowed old pages torn from a book? Not my finest moment.
I'd like to have those pages, if you don't mind.
They're not here. I thought if Apollonia wasn't interested in the map on the pages, perhaps it would lead to something that would intrigue her. So, I followed the map to what I can only describe as an enchanted cave of some kind. And you see what happened next? Here's an idea. Why don't you meet me at the edge of the Forbidden Forest, and I'll show you where to find the pages.
Why did I need the toast to get in here?
Oh, that was Apollonia's idea. Seems some squids love toast. They should have taught you that at Hogwarts.
No.
How is it possible to steal from Peeves, a poltergeist?
I didn't steal the pages from his ghostly form. I merely found them in his wake of destruction. He has a penchant for wrecking things. Books, bottles, suits of armor. Whatever's sure to cause the most chaos. He dropped them after a particularly aggressive romp through the library.
I think I can guess how you died, but who did it to you?
I was having a look around when I suddenly sensed a refreshing breeze. After that, I felt, well, lightheaded. That's all I remember. Hence, if you do visit the cave, be prepared. I can't tell you what for specifically, but you seem a perceptive sort. Beware a light breeze.
I suppose if that's the only way for me to get those pages, I'll meet you at the forest.
I'm sure the pages are still tucked in my waistcoat. If you don't mind the sight of a, well, my decapitated skeleton, they're yours for the taking.
Hello, Scrope. Thanks to you, I was able to enter Apollina's grotto. The toast was the key. I met a ghost there, Richard Jackdaw, who's agreed to lead me to the pages I've been looking for.
Oh, that boy was never good enough for Apollonia. Oh, what of the Black Family ring?
I'm sorry to say that Jackdaw sold it long ago.
Sad news indeed. Scrope shall need to think of another way to impress the headmaster. Well, Scrope takes some consolation in knowing that the young Slytherin found what they needed.
I did. Thank you again, Scrope. You're a credit to House Elves.